we will start considering from phase 3. Phase 3 being the time from which the SHG group started to develop and which ultimately culminated into the formation of MFIs. Formal structural MFIs we are talking about here. Now, phase 3 could be divided into two groups, that is the peer pressure, that is SHG, self-help group, and the second part being the establishment of MFIs typically of non-profit origins. Now, peer pressure, this lays the foundation in the cooperative movement of 1960s. That is to say, when you are forming a self-help group of women, that is 4, 5, 6, 7 women are coming together to form such a group, which would be responsible for taking money from the loan, taking money as a loan from the bank, and would start functioning. They would have to bank on the social capital. In this case, the bank itself starts working on the basis of social capital. Social capital is through the networks that they have built, social capital through the relatives, through the people, and most importantly through the people who are the member of the SHGs. That is, the SHG members would create pressure onto each other to ensure that the money that has been taken from the bank would be utilized properly, and in the long run they will be in a position to generate more cash and pay back the loan amount that they have taken from the bank. So this is all about the peer pressure. Now, this peer pressure later on culminated into MFIs. Previously, the NGOs were working to get the bank loans to these SHGs. But later on, when MFI revolution happened in India, the microfinancial institution started taking loan from the bank at a particular interest rates and started lending it to the SHGs. So in this case also, if we see through the SHGs, the MFIs are actually banking upon the social capital through which the money will be recovered, and in the long run the money that is generated that would not only give profit to the SHG groups but also to the MFIs, and in due with that they will be able to return the money that they have borrowed from the bank at a particular interest rates. So overall, MFIs is a non-profit organization. So when an MFI is functioning, it does not look for its own profit, but rather only looks at the profit of the SHG groups that is functioning within it. And that is the reason why they take money from the bank to ensure that the SHGs have a free flow of fund and free flow of supply of money.